Hi guys, this is Haley. Today I'm reviewing one of the most hype makeup brands at the moment, and that is Rare Beauty by Selena Gomez. For me, it takes time to get all this product, and I got this product like 4 days ago. And since I got this product, I've been testing 3 days in a row. I also haven't watched any other YouTube creators review video about this product because I just wanted to make my own opinion without distracting by others. So instead of doing a first impression video, I decide to review each product more in detail and compare to other brands' products. I think this is the most exciting launch for me in 2020 because first, who doesn't love Selena Gomez? And also she believes that real beauty comes from embracing your natural self and celebrating your uniqueness rather than just covering all of them or following beauty standard. And that is exactly what I want to deliver in my channel. I've been making a makeup video without using a foundation or specific makeup products. I think that's why many of you guys asked me to do a review of Rare Beauty products. I really admire she's been trying to deliver those positive messages to the world, and especially young generation. Especially nowadays, it is very easy to have those kind of pressure to look unrealistic way because of social media. I love the brand itself and what they're trying to deliver, but it doesn't mean that I love all their products. So I'm so excited to give you guys a review on each product. So let's just dive into it. Apart from a mist and blotting paper, I purchased all the products, and the reason why I didn't purchase two of them is because I am not a person who use a mist before makeup or a blotting paper after makeup or to like fix my makeup. So I don't think I can be a right person to give a really good review on each product. So I'm just gonna start with a primer. So first I'm going to review this illuminating primer, and I actually got the sample size or mini size because I was just special about this product, so I didn't purchase a full size, but I kind of regret from getting a mini size because it's actually really nice product. Even though they describe this as a primer, they didn't put any silicone in it, and they claim it to be non-comedogenic. As they didn't put any silicone in it, it doesn't blur or diffuse the look of your skin texture, so it is more like hydrating lotion or a bit of moisturizer with subtle glitters. I would say this is something makes your skin really glowy and dewy with subtle shimmer. When you look at the ingredients, the glycerin comes in the second place, so that's why it makes your skin really hydrating. So it is definitely more like moisturizer. Compared to other makeup primer, it has pretty simple inky list. And generally speaking, when it comes to skincare or makeup products, if a product has simple inky list, it is less likely to irritate your skin. Compared to other makeup primer, I think this can be a gentle option, but if you want something like blurring your pores or skin texture, this might be not a right product for you. But personally, I really love this type of hydrating primer with really subtle shimmers. So if you like that kind of look, it's definitely worth a try. And the next product is a foundation. And this is their Liquid Touch Weightless Foundation. And I'm using the shade 230 and shade. And I actually didn't expect that much for foundation because whenever they claim that it's really natural looking foundation, I always found it's not really natural for me because I don't use a foundation very often, so I'm not used to using a foundation all up on my face. So that's why I didn't really expect foundation to reach my expectation. When I tried this product, I was a bit shocked because it looks very natural with a really decent amount of coverage, and they recommend to shake this product before using it to make sure the product's mixing really well. And the applicator has a duffel applicator, so it's so easy to sweep all over your face. And when it comes to texture, it's a bit watery and very lightweight, but it set really into the skin well once you blend it out. And when it comes to coverage, they claim this product has a medium coverage, and I totally agree with that. It has a medium coverage and it's buildable, so if you want more coverage, you can put one more layer. When it comes to shade, I guess many of you guys wonder what shade you should get because there are like 40 different shades. So they have like a little mini quiz. You can do it online on their website. So it turns out it perfectly matches with my skin tone. So I'm so happy that I found the right shade for my skin tone. I'm seeing people compare Rare Beauty products with the Fenty Beauty products, but I think they are totally different brands, and the foundation especially are totally different. The Fenty Beauty one has higher coverage and much more like matte finish. And to apply the foundation, Rare Beauty launched this foundation brush and a sponge. Whenever I tried this foundation brush, I found this a bit harsh on my skin after blending foundation with this brush, so I don't think I'm gonna continue using this brush. But I actually really like this sponge because it's really soft and it's easy to blend after blending a foundation all over my face. Next product I'm reviewing is concealer, and it's liquid touch brightening concealer. When it comes to texture, this is kind of a thicker version of foundation. It's more matte and has more coverage, and it blends really easily fingertips, so I don't feel like I need to use any like brush or sponge. And the coverage has medium to full coverage, but more in medium size compared to other like full coverage concealer. It's definitely more natural, and I really like the fact that it's really hydrating compared to other concealer out there. As they describe this as a brightening concealer, they intentionally make the shades lighter than foundation shades. And next product is this blush. It's called Soft Pinch Liquid Blush, and I got the shade Zoe. And the shade, they describe this as a muted peach, and it has dewy finish. Depending on the shade, they have dewy finish or matte finish, and this product has a dewy finish, but it doesn't have any glitters in it. And when I first tried this product on the back of my hand, I thought it's a liquid lipstick because it is so high pigmented. So I was kind of surprised when I found this liquid blush. But anyway, it is so high pigmented, so I think you have to be careful when you apply. So whenever I try this product, I just put a really really tiny amount and blend with my fingertips. And when it comes to texture, it's really rich compared to other liquid blush out there. I personally really like a cream or liquid blush, and the reason why I love this kind of blush is it's really natural looking and it's just easy to use. And when it's too high pigmented, it's more likely leave the edges and it's hard to blend like evenly. And for me, it's a bit hard to get like products evenly all over my cheeks, so I wish it's a bit more natural. Now if I compare this liquid blush with the cream blush from Fenty and liquid blush from Blossier, which are my favorite, you can definitely see that Rare Beauty one is much more high pigmented, but after a few minutes it blends into my natural skin really beautifully, so it doesn't look intense as much as when I put this in the first place. But it definitely requires more practice or skills to blend evenly or apply evenly. And the next product is highlighter. It's Positive Light Liquid Luminizer, and I got the shade Mesmerize. It has a liquid texture, and once I blend into my skin, it feels a bit slippery. It's a bit hard to control amount of use or where you want to place. I really like the result after using this product. It just reminds me of this Glossier Play highlighter concentrate in the shade Platinum Rose. You could see that it looks very similar, but Rare Beauty one is pinker. Even though this is a liquid highlighter, this is high pigmented and little amount goes all the way, so you don't need to put a lot of amount to get that lay skin look. The thing about this product is I think this is too big to be as a highlighter. Even though I purchased this Glossier Play highlighter like 1.5 years ago, I've been using this more often than other highlighter. I'm still using it, but this highlighter is almost like double size as this Glossier highlighter, so I'm concerned that I don't think I can finish the product until it expires unless I use this every single day. I personally think that it'll be better if they comes in smaller size, but anyway, I really like this product, so I might try other shades. And the next product is brow products, and this is called Brow Harmony, And I got the shade Deep Brown. And this is actually a dual product. You can get like a brow gel and gel brow pencil. Whenever I do my brow makeup, I don't use something really intense like gel product or really like high pigmented products. So I just want something look very natural looking. As is of gel formula, I found it is really high pigmented product. But if you want something really high pigmented brow product, I think this product might be a right option for you. And the brow gel is just nothing really special. I think it's just same as other brow gel. It has a color in it, but I personally don't like this really tiny brush because it's easy to get all over my skin around my brow. As a brow gel, it's fine, but if you want to hold your brows really strongly, I personally recommend the Anastasia Beverly Hills brow products. Their brow gel is amazing. It holds the brows really well, but I don't think this is nothing really special. So yeah. And the next product is liquid eyeliner, and it's called Matte Liquid Eyeliner. Whenever I see Selena Gomez makeup look, I always see her like iconic wing eyeliner, so this is something definitely reminds of her look. And I personally don't draw wing eyeliner that often, and when I draw some eyeliner, I normally tight line and draw a really small wing eyeliner. I could say this is more like a lacquer-like eyeliner. So this is definitely really intense black liquid eyeliner. I found this a bit easy to draw wing eyeliner, and when the brush is a bit weak or too flexible, it's sometimes hard to draw like really solid, a good wing eyeliner. But I found this brush tip is a pretty solid to draw a wing eyeliner I want. So I think this is just a fine product. But the thing is, when I cleanse my makeup, I always start with cleansing oil. When I tried to remove all the makeup I did with Rare Beauty products, I found this eyeliner didn't get removed that easily, so it took a bit longer time to melt the eyeliner and remove. I think you might need eye makeup remover to remove this eyeliner. I actually went to the gym yesterday with wearing this eyeliner, and I found that it stays pretty well. And for lips, I got these two products, and first one is this With Gratitude Dewy Lip Balm, and I got the shade Compliment. But I would rather say that this is just like sheer lipstick, because if you think about hydrating lip balm, you would think that something really sheer or really subtle color payoff. So I thought it'd be really natural, but it turned out it's just like hydrating lipstick. And they put shea butter, so it feels really nourishing and hydrating, but it's a bit slippery when you apply all over your lips, and I found this can be removed very easily, especially when you're wearing masks. So I don't think I would use that often. I really wanted to like this product because I really like hydrating lip balm or tinted lip balm, but I'm just gonna try other shades because I found that they're more like lighter shade, and I got this a pretty intense shade, so I will see if I like other shades. So I'm gonna keep you guys updated on that. Another lip product I got is Lips of Olay Matte Lip Cream, and I got the shade Inspire. It has a like whipped cream formula, and it's really really lightweight, and it has a velvety finish, so it feels comfortable on my lips. But the thing is, it does not really set onto my lips, so I think there is so much better products out there than this product. At least this product does not dry out my lips. So yeah, I think this is my thought about Rare Beauty products. I hope you guys find this video helpful. If I have to pick like one specific product as my favorite, I think I would say foundation, because I was so surprised that they make this like really natural looking with decent amount of coverage. I think it's definitely worth a try, and I think that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.